Hello everybody, happy Friday. It's Facebook Friday once again, and this week we are using the adorable Racing By stamp set. This is not a bundle, it's just a stamp set. I wish there were dies, but there's not. So get your scissors ready, get your paper snips ready. We will be fussy cutting. This is a really cute stamp set, and I have some really cute things. Last week I asked for ideas for treats, because I couldn't find something to go with it to make a treat, and I found something. It is really cute. So I can't wait to show you. I didn't even know it existed. When I went to Walmart and saw it, I was like, oh my gosh, it's made to be. So I will show you that. That's gonna be our last project. Let me make sure I'm in the right place. All right, let's get started because I have a lot of things to tell you. And our project's kind of long today, all three of them. Okay, where do I want to start? Let's do Club Create. If you can see behind me, Club Create for May will be shipping out either Monday or Tuesday. We've had a little hiccup in our Club Create kits this month. Something is lost in the mail, and oh look, it gave me a thumbs up because I was giving a thumbs up. That's funny. Something is lost in the mail. I was trying to hold out to see if it would show up, but I don't think it's going to. So anyway, those will go out either Monday or Tuesday. So June's Club Create kit now, registration or the subscription period is now open for June's Club Create kit. It features the Adventurous Sky bundle. The whole suite of products is super, super cute. I love the airplane and the paper. I love all of it. So that is June's Club Create kit. It is $45. It includes about $20, $25 in product. You get five projects, a video, and a PDF. And if you stay in Club Create for 6 months in a row, you get a $25 product credit, which is awesome. So the $45 also includes shipping. That's what you get. And you can always add on the bundle. If you don't have a bundle, I always give that option to add on. And when you do that, I pay the tax and shipping on it for you. So if you would like to subscribe, there is a link at the top of my blog called Club Create. And you can cancel anytime. I always want to make sure you guys know that. There's no, like you're not locked in. You can stay for however long. I have some people who've been here from the very beginning, which I think is about 3 years now. So that's amazing. That is amazing. But also some that come for a couple months, then they drop out for a while and they come back. So it's up to you. It's flexible. I think it's pretty fun. Jessica says she loves her Club Create. Thank you, Jessica. All right, I'm going to flip you guys over. Let me do that real quick. And there is something that I completely forgot to tell you guys about last week. And I felt so dumb afterwards. I was like, how can I forget this? The starter kit, you guys, during a new catalog, usually, Stampin' Up! Will give us a starter kit special. Starter kit is always special, if you will, because it's $99. You get $125 of product of your choice, anything you want, and free shipping. But during June, the new catalog period, same price, $99, you get $125 product of your choice, but you're also gonna get the five in-color ink pads, the five markers, the pack of designer series paper, and the pack of the in-color cardstock, which is always a fun thing to do, to get it all at one time in your starter kit. So if you're interested in the starter kit, there is a tab at the top of my blog that says join. If you click that, it will give you lots of information about the benefits of buying the starter kit. I just noticed right here, it says all of that is an $82 value. That is amazing. So for $99, you get the $82 value, plus you still get to pick out $125 of product of your choice. Then you get to enjoy a 20% discount, which can grow if you grow in your Stampin' Up! Business. You also get my PDFs for free. You get my class kits at a discount. You get to be part of my team. So there's lots of benefits of buying the starter kit, and even more added benefit in June if you buy it. So if you're interested in that, make sure you check it out. It's through the end of June. If you have questions, June, May. I've been saying June the whole time. I told you guys last week, I am so off. I feel like this is June. Scratch everything I just said and insert May. Till the end of May 2024. Man. Oh yeah, Nancy, you also, I forgot. I always forget that too. You get a paper pumpkin kit in your starter kit, a past paper pumpkin kit. It's a huge value. I mean, it really is a huge value. So May, Erica, it's May. It's not June. Stop jumping ahead. It is May 2024. You have until the end of May to take advantage of the starter kit. Don't wait till June because then it'll be over. And then you'll be mad at me because I told you June. It's May. May, 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 May. Okay. Also, did you guys get this email? Free shipping on Tuesday. On $75 or more. So unfortunately, that's after the closing period for Facebook Friday, but that'll be into next week's Facebook Friday. You can still earn next week's Facebook Friday projects. I may be cooking up a little something for that too. We'll see. Next week, I think we're going to do the friendly fins, the little shark, and little stingray. So cute. If I can get those projects together, that's what we'll be doing. So if you wait till Tuesday and you're going to spend more than $75, you'll save on shipping. If your order is less than $75, you might as well order this weekend and get the Racing by Facebook Friday projects for free. I just want to make sure I told you guys that because I forgot last week to tell you about the starter kit and I felt bad. Okay. Paper shares. This is the last time I'm going to tell you about paper shares. I'm going to close it next week. And I've already ordered most of it. I will put in one more order if anybody else wants to join in. You have three options, 6x6, 6x12, and 12x12. Next week I will be finishing up my in-color club kits and getting those out, and then I will start working on these. So these will ship, next week's not the last week of May, is it, right? No, these will ship probably the last week of May. Okay. Okay. That is that. You get a sampling of each of the new papers. That's what a paper share is. I'm sure you guys already know that, but you get either like a 6x6 piece, a 6x12 piece, or if you're really into it, a 12x12 piece. That's what I love paper. So I would always go with a 12x12 option. And you get these cool little pockets to keep them in too. Okay. All right, everybody got their new catalogs? If you need a catalog, let me know. I can send you one. I wanted to say that. Let's see, what else? Okay, that's it. Let's look at prizes from last week. Let me move things out of the way. I'm zipping through today because our projects are not simple. I'll say that, they are not simple. So we gotta move things along. All right, Sarah Mitchell, you are the winner from last week. Thank you for sharing my video on Facebook. You have won the Country Flowers Bundle. Sarah, I don't think I have your mailing address. Email me, please. Make sure that I have. Sometimes I have, you guys, you would be amazed how many people have the same name. There are some names that I have four or five different customers with the exact same name. So I'm always hesitant to send it to somebody in my address book because I never know if that's the same person. So Sarah Mitchell, if that is you from last week and you shared my video on Facebook, email me, okay? Because I'd love to send this to you as a thank you for sharing my video. All right, Tune In is the prize for next week. I love this set. I just did a group of swap cards using this. This will be Facebook Friday coming up in a couple of weeks, maybe week after next. It's so fun. It is really, really a fun set. So if you'd like to win this set, just share on Facebook or YouTube and I will pick a winner next week. Okay. The other part of Facebook Friday is the free make and takes. I have a host code that is attached to this class, basically. This Racing By class is what we're doing. We're going to make three projects using the Racing By stamp set. And if you like them and you would like me to send you the kit so that you can make them, if you put in an order between now and Monday at midnight using this host code and it's over $35, I'll send you a kit. And this is what they look like. They come with everything that you need, except for the stamped images. There's a big no-no in the Stamping Up world, we are not allowed to send pre-stamped images. It's against policy. So you have to stamp your own images. I mean, that's part of the fun, right? Is stamping your own images. But anyway, this is kind of what they look like. I do send you a little thank you tag. That's not part of the projects. That's a thank you tag. But you have to do your own stamping. But other than that, everything else will be done for you. Die cutting, scoring, that kind of stuff. Your deadline for that is Monday at midnight. Any order over $35 using that host code will get these. I cut them on Tuesdays and ship them on Wednesdays. Okay, I sped through that pretty quickly, didn't I? All right, how are you guys? Everybody good? Nicole, that tune-in bundle is so fun. I can't wait to really get to sit down and play with it. Marianne, I know, free shipping always happens. Well, just, you know what? Come up with another order. That's what you need to do. We never know when free shipping is coming. That's the thing. We never know. It's a surprise. All right. So the first card we're going to make is this card. And I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. One thing I struggled with this set is that I don't have any black and white paper. And I really wanted to use black and white paper with this stamp set. We needed that background, that checkered background. So I'm going to show you how to make that checkered background. You may have a stamp that makes that, or you may have some paper that's already like that. I do not. And so I was being resourceful and I said, let's make it, of course. So let's do that first and then we'll make the little car. I'm gonna show you how I did the little fire too, okay? Okay, so to make the background, you're gonna need a piece of basic white that is 5.5 by 5.5, okay? And then, do I have my adhesive sheets here? I don't think that I do. I have a pre-cut one. Oh yeah, let's see, here we go. Okay, so you can use just your Stampin' Seal on this, but it's really easy if you just use your adhesive sheets on this. So lay it down, peel it back, lay it down. Oh, I think I did it crooked, but whatever. And then, oh yeah, I didn't go all the way to the end. That's okay, because I have a sample already made. Just cut this off like this. And then you have basically a sticker sheet. And so we've done this many times with die cuts. But when you are doing something like weaving or you need, you know, little strips, it's really a good way to use your adhesive strips as well. So now peel off the backing and you've got this sticky strip. Did I ever tell you guys the story about the sticky strip in my garage? Do you guys use those sticky strips to catch things in your garage? You know, the exterminator, they'll bring those big trays and they're real sticky and then it's always gross what you end up finding. One time my dog, since we've been in this house, my dog got trapped in the garage. We didn't know he was in there. He was fine. But he found the sticky strip and it had a dead bird on it. And he put his paw on the sticky strip and then he was stuck to the sticky strip, dragging the sticky strip around with a dead bird on it. And I was home alone, of course. And I had to get it off him. It was traumatizing for both of us. Very traumatizing. So every time I say sticky strip, that's what I think of. But this sticky strip's not gonna have dead bird. We're gonna do black and white stripes today. All right, cut a bunch of half inch black and white strips, okay? Basic black and basic white. And we're just gonna go down. You never know what you're gonna learn here about me when you come to Facebook Friday. I saved stories for you guys. No snake stories this week, knock on wood. I mean, that doesn't mean that they're not out there. Ugh. But we haven't had any since the last one. Sticky strip, that's probably a bad idea with all their snakes that we have. I told my husband, you knew that bird was on that. Why didn't you throw it away? And which, okay, sidebar, very sad story, right? Poor bird. But that's not, we're not going to focus on that right now. We're gonna focus on poor Charlie and his paw stuck to the sticky strip and his poor mom having to figure out how to get it off without tearing his paw off. We were traumatized. We all were traumatized. Ellie was here, my oldest daughter. She was here and she helped me. Why? Why do we have pets? Oh no. Oh no, Lisa. Oh my God. Did you have to take care of it? She says she hit a cardinal and it was stuck to her grill. Oh, that is traumatizing. That is traumatizing. They're so pretty. Okay, so here, you've made your strips, right? And I actually had one already made. I didn't need to go all the way down. I just got caught up in the story. Now, we're gonna take our trimmer and, well, it would help if I got it the right way. So, Susan, I used Goo Gone. Do you guys know Goo Gone? I'm sure you do. And it got it off. I was like, I have no idea how I'm gonna do this because, I mean, it would probably pull his skin off, but Goo Gone, it worked. Okay, I'm gonna cut the edge off just to make sure it's nice and straight. And now we're gonna go down and we're gonna cut these into half inch strips. All right, you just slide. I tried hot water and soap, that did nothing. I tried peeling it off and that was obviously not gonna work. So then I was like, okay, Goo Gone, let's get the Goo Gone. And that worked. So if you don't have Goo Gone in your cabinet, not only does it remove sticky residue from your scissors, it will remove your dog's paw from a sticky pad. I guess they're called sticky pads. Ugh. Oh, I know, this poor little bird. Sad. I mean, what a terrible way to go. All right, let's not think about it. Everybody stop. Stop thinking about it. Okay, look how cute. Can you guys see where we're going with this? Now we've got these black and white strips, and we're gonna get another piece of basic white. That is 4 by 5 1/4. And I am again gonna use my sticky. Is this the right size? Yes, it feels like maybe it's too big. We may have to cut it down. Yeah, I think it is. Ah, you know what? I used the wrong one. Oh well, okay. We will make it work. It'll be fine. We'll cut it before we put our things on it. You just need a 4 by 5 1/4 inch piece. And let's trim it down, make it the right size. I don't know why I have two here. Now, if you want to come back and watch this with more detail and clarity without the sidebar stories, there is an individual recording of this project on YouTube, okay? All right, and then you won't have to think about the sad story that I just told you. All right, peel these off. Not sure what I got stuck on there. Some kind of something that was stuck to my finger. All right, now we're gonna take this and we're gonna set this on here like this. And then we're going to, each time we go down, we're gonna slide it over so that we've got the white and then the black, okay? White and the black. That one's not right. Let's do this one. I don't know, these measurements. One of my strips doesn't quite seem to be half an inch. It's not long enough. It's all right, it'll all work out. Let's just keep going. All right, keep your, just alternating black and white, keep going all the way down until, I feel like I didn't cut this piece the right size because they're not going all the way to the end. And we should have plenty left over. All right, one more. Now, if I send this to you in a kit next week, please know that you're gonna cut your own strips, okay? Because when I have to do a bunch of them, they're not gonna be straight. It's gonna be better if you do it. So I will send you a piece of black and a piece of white for you to cut your own strips. All right, now get all of those off. Am I at 5 1/4? I feel like this piece is a little bit, no, that's right. Oh, a little bit more, a little bit more. Just making it even on the edges, okay? And there is your black and white checkered piece. You know, I didn't do such a great job on this one, but you guys get it, right? You know what I'm supposed to be doing, what I'm trying to do. You know what? I'm going to cut it a little bit smaller. I don't like those ends. I don't know what happened there. So let's make it 3 3/4 by 5. Oh, man, is this how today is going to go? Is this how we're going to do it? Hold, please. This little trimmer doesn't do well with thick pieces. Just talk amongst yourself while I fix this, all right? Just talk amongst yourself. Anybody drowning in the rain over there? It's been a crazy rainy week. Not here, of course. All the rain has missed us. It's been crazy. Okay, there we go. That looks better. Black and white checkered piece. And we're just gonna put that on a real red card base. And I feel like it's still not the right size. Still not the right size. Hold, please. You know, sometimes things go the way you want them to, and sometimes they do not. Now, you're gonna adhere this onto your card base, okay? Real red, black and white, super cute. And I've got a piece of silver foil for our race car to sit on, so let's put that right across there. Okay, now we're ready for the race car. Let's grab our pieces and we're gonna stamp. You've got a lot of options for this race car. You can color it with blends, which is what we're gonna do in a minute. Hold on, I'm trying to find the right stamp. It's missing, it's not over here. Oh, here it is, hello. Where's the stamp case? You can stamp it outlined and then stamp this on the inside. But what we're gonna do is just stamp it without the outline. That's what I did the first time, and I realized later that maybe you're supposed to stamp it inside the outline, but I'm just gonna show you that you don't even have to do that. All right, so real red, and then grab the little tires. We need black. And you've got two tire choices. Oh yeah, you guys have lots of rain. Oh, Jan, are you in Corpus? Yeah, so East Texas, that direction, east of us, seem to have gotten a lot of rain. Us, of course not. A lot of thunder, a lot of lightning, not a lot of rain. Okay, so now we also have this cute little guy right here that you can stamp. He's a little race car driver. Isn't he cute? Okay, now, get your paper snips. I don't want to hear any complaining. I don't want to hear it. I know some of you don't like to fussy cut, but it's just the way it goes sometimes. We're going to fussy cut. Get your paper snips. Go all the way around. And you know, for the sake of the video, I already did it. I got it done. Boom. So that we didn't have to wait for me to fussy cut everything. Okay, now, this little piece of fire right here, do you guys know where that's from? That is from the Bistro burger set, the hamburger. Have you guys looked at those dies? They have a knife, a jalapeno, fire. So of course we're gonna use the fire here with our race car. Now, it's basic white. Pretend like you didn't see that it was already yellow on the other side, because that was an accident from yesterday's video, and I thought, you know what, we're gonna flip it over and just use the white side. So get your Daffodil Delight and your blending brush and just cover it like this, okay? And then get your other blending brush and your pumpkin pie, and you just wanna do the top edges of the flame like that. All right, so now we have fire. And we just need a little bit of this. You know, I feel like we need just a little bit more orange on the top there. We just need like two little sections. So cut off, let's see, I'm gonna cut that piece and that piece like that. It doesn't matter which two you use. Okay, now get your little car and put some adhesive back there. And we'll start with a smaller one, okay? And then let's put a little more adhesive and we'll stack it on top of the larger one like that. So now he looks like he's zooming, right? He's flying. Now, Patty, did you say that the Indy 500 is at the end of the month? Somebody, Patty, was it Patty or was it Patient? Somebody said that. I don't follow racing, but that's good to know. I'm sure some of you do. All right, get your race car. Get some dimensionals and put that on there. Now, I have a stylus shape banner and I'm going to stamp it in real red and memento black. And because it's a photopolymer, I can do it like this, where I'm just inking up part of it. I can just see through it so that I'm just inking that part. And then I'll do the other part like this. If that's tricky and you have a hard time with that, just use your masking post-it tape or your post-it note or masking paper or whatever and mask it off and then do it. All right, racing by to say happy birthday. Here in my family, we say happy woof day. Happy woof day, because when my daughter was little, she had a major speech impediment. And so there's this hilarious video where she's saying happy woof day. But I'll say it correctly. Happy birthday. Wouldn't this make a cute little birthday card for a little boy? All right, happy birthday. Now, last but not least, we're going to use these really cool trinkets called industrial trinkets. And let me show you guys what they look like. One side looks like that and one side looks like that. They are with the airplane suite, all right? But they go really well with this. So we're gonna put a dot and a dot and a dot. And we will get our, take your pick tool and we're gonna set these down. If I can get it to pick up, they're heavy. Let's see, I need some more sticky. My sticky is worn down. Let's get some more. Don't you guys love the take your pick tool? I've told y'all this before. When people join my group, they have to answer a question. What is your favorite tool? And I would say 75% of you say the take your pick tool. Nicole, it's so cute. It's so cute. Just wait, just wait. I've got some even cuter things. All right, so we've got those on there. Last but not least, do you think that a masculine card can have a bow? Well, I do. So we're putting one on. Just a little baker's twine bow. Never hurt anybody. Okay, let me ask this. Who's been watching Young Sheldon? We talk about TV shows here, and I know some of you have told me I need to watch it, and I haven't watched it, and all of a sudden now it's ending, and my mom keeps telling me all about it. So I started watching it this weekend, season one, and then last night I watched the season finale of what, like season six or whatever, and it's so good. So all of you that told me to watch Young Sheldon, I'm in. I'm gonna watch it this summer. I'm gonna watch all the seasons. It's so good, you guys. Okay, just my little input. Chris, you love it. It's so good. Trisha, it's so good, right? So good. Jana, it's so good. I haven't even watched all the seasons, and I was bawling all through the episode last night. So, yeah, it's very good. Okay, there you go, you guys. What do you think? Cute, fun, little birthday card for a boy or not a boy, whatever. Okay, so now you know how to make your black and white checkered paper too, if you don't have any black and white checkered designer series paper. Okay, so there's that. Next, we're gonna do some watercolor. And I told you guys last week when we made our slider card last week that we were going to make another slider card this week, and this is what we're doing. Now notice, see how this is bending like this? I discovered that one piece is too thin, so we're going to double up and make that thicker so that it doesn't do that. But look at him, he's flying through the flames. Isn't that fun? Okay, so that's what we're going to do. The first thing we need to do is our watercoloring. And I am going to get out your kosher salt, you guys. I'm going to use the kosher salt today. I like the way it leaves those speckles on our watercolor. And I think for this, for like the smoke, I think the speckles are definitely needed. Okay, you're going to need water. You're going to need your water painter. You're going to need basic gray and smoky slate. Did I put my smoky slate away? I was using it. Hold on. Ooh, is it here? Is it here? Is it here? Hold on. Let me look. Did I put it away? Yeah, I did. Okay. So you can get a clear block, and you can dip it in your ink pad and have a little palette, or you can do this, which is what I did with the other one. You squeeze it like that, and it puts the ink there in your lid. So I'll do both ways, okay? Look, there's a dimensional. Okay, all right, so you just take your clear block and you do that, and now you've got a little palette. So we've got smoky slate and we've got basic gray. And I'm gonna get my paper just a little bit wet, kind of prime it a little bit. And then I'm gonna get this, because I want it to be kind of wet. I'm gonna drop this color in, and I want it to just be messy and just kind of bloppy, is that a word? For the salt to work, we're gonna really need a lot of water. So make sure you're using your water and just dropping color. I want a little bit more of the basic gray. So I'm gonna do that, and we'll do that. I'm just gonna add, just kind of, I don't know, you know, like boop, boop, boop. Make it kind of messy like that. A little bit more water. Okay, so once it's nice and messy and smoky, get your kosher, just your kosher, coarse kosher salt, and sprinkle it on. Okay, now it's gonna dry in about 20 minutes. Takes a while. Give it time, don't rush it. And oh, I just put that salt in the recycle bin. Oops, sorry. All right, now here's what it kind of looks like when it's done. Can you see the speckly, kind of grainy look? I'm gonna add some more to this, because more is more. I'm gonna take my basic black. You guys know, I just can't do simple. I'm gonna take my basic black salmon blend, and I'm gonna just add in some more, make it really smoky. Okay, all right, now there's our background. So basic black card base. Your piece is gonna be kind of warped because it got wet. So really be generous with your adhesive. And then we're gonna stick it down on here like that. Okay, now we'll come back to this. Let's make our car. We're gonna try to go in order. Here is our car, our piece of basic white. I'm gonna stamp the car, which I've already cut out, but let's go ahead and I'll show you how I colored it this time. Memento black. Well, look at that. Let's try that again. Okay, and then let's get the little flag. And we're gonna stamp that two times. Look at my fingers. They're a mess. Two times. Resident Alien Lisa, did you like it? It's so weird. It's so weird. Joan, is it out? Bridgerton, part 3. Did it come out? Oh my. I didn't know. I thought it was later in the month. I do like Bridgerton. Oh yes, let's do our little guy too. I really like the little racing helmet. One thing I need to warn you about though, My stamp, if I push too hard, it gets ink up into the face mask, which then transfers over to your paper. So don't push down real hard with your photopolymers. Okay, oh, Bridgerton. Is it good? Have you watched it yet? Bridgerton. You know, I don't know what to even say about Bridgerton. It's good. I read all the books too. Okay, we're gonna do light pumpkin pie. I forgot the tires, we'll add those in. And if you don't want to color, there are two options. You can stamp it on colored cardstock, or you can stamp the other two filler images like we did in the last one. Now I'm gonna take my dark and I'm gonna add shadow back here like this and down here and then kind of up around the tire area like that. Then we're gonna take that light and we're just gonna blend, pull that color up towards the top. Now the top of the car is gonna be the lightest. So flick all that color up towards the lightest part. Okay, now let's do the tires. One and two. Now, get out your paper snips, snip, 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 and then here you go. You've got that and that and that. Okay, now let's go ahead and do the fire. This time you're gonna need two pieces of fire. Two pieces of fire. Does that make sense? Two fire die cuts. It is so weird. Yes, you laughed. It's so funny. Maybe not everybody will think Resident Alien is funny, but my husband and I think it's hilarious. I'm embarrassed to admit it because it's really dumb, but we really think it's funny. Okay, again with the fire, we're gonna do the same thing. Daffodil Delight. And then, man, I really want to go wash my fingers. And then you get your pumpkin pie. And we'll just do the tips of the fire. Like that. And then I got a little crazy this time with the fire. And we're going to take, make sure everything's out of the way. We're going to take Dark Cajun Craze and just flick some of that onto the fire. Okay? Just for more excitement in our fire. Look at that, isn't that fun? Okay, I think we've got all of our pieces ready to go. You're gonna need, first things first, you're gonna need 2 3/4 inch pieces of basic black. And I wanna make sure that these are 3/4 inch because yesterday they were not. Okay, they are. All right, 2 3/4 of an inch by 5 1/2. 5 1/4. Five and a fourth. And you're gonna adhere them together. We're just strengthening that pulling mechanism so that it doesn't do that whole like bendy thing, which annoys me. Now, get your cute, very vanilla and black ribbon. And you just need a little loop like this and your stapler. And this is going to stick out so that you can pull it through, right? Like that. Now you're gonna need we've made this mechanism before. You guys may recognize this. We've done this a few times. You're gonna need a piece of basic black that is 2 1/2 by 5 1/4. On the short side, you're gonna score it at 1 and at 2. We're just making like a little tunnel for that piece that we just made. Okay, whoa, my thing's about to fall. So burnish those lines real well. Get your tear and tape. And we're going to put tear and tape down, all the way down. And, nope, we don't want an X-Acto. We just need this part. Penelope and Colin. You know, Joan, I find Penelope and Colin to be a weird mix. I didn't really get that story. But I think, from what I understand, it's going to be good. All right, now you fold that little half inch in and then you fold that over, okay? So there's your little tunnel and this is gonna go in like this, okay? There we go, we've got that like that. Okay, now you've got a piece of either basic gray or smoky slate or even gray granite designer series paper from the neutral stack. It is 2.5. But I think 3 might be a little bit better. And we want the hill to go this way. So we're just gonna cut from this corner to just about an inch. It doesn't have to be exact, okay? To make that hill like that. And then I am gonna take my adhesive and run it down like that. And we're gonna line this little thing up like this. Let's take this out. And we are gonna have to snip some of it off. Okay, so see how it's sticking out? This is what it looks like. So now you're just gonna trim off those pieces that are too long. Okay, and then this will go back in like that. And if it sticks out the back side, we can trim that too, like that. All right, now you want this part to stick out a little bit so that they know they're supposed to pull it. Okay, now exactly like we did last week, 4 magnets. You need 2, whoa, they have a mind of their own. Where did it go? It's probably stuck to this. Okay, whatever, 2, we'll get 2 more. 2 and 4. And then you're gonna get your glue dots, 2 glue dots per magnet. And when you start with them in a stack, okay, and turn it over, put this right here on the wheels like that. And then 2. Did it go under the paper, under this? Oh, there it is, thank you. Good eyes. We'll save that one for next time. All right, so now we've got those 2. This is a stack right here, right? We've got 2 and 2. We're gonna put glue dots on top. This is where your fingers are gonna get stuck. And then 2 glue dots on this one. 2 glue dots for some reason holds a lot better than 1. Okay, now I'm gonna put this down here like, this is out of the tunnel, right? This is just that little strip. I'm gonna put it like about right there. Okay, push it down. Take your magnet, take your car off. And slide it in. Into the tunnel. Now before we put that on there, we're gonna take this strip and we're gonna stamp, what sentiment did I use? I used the happy birthday. I need to clean it. We'll stamp it in Memento Black, right on the bottom edge. We're gonna need to trim this one too. Okay, like that. Now, careful not to trim that part. Let's just match those edges. Like that. And then we'll get our car and it will find its magnets. Wherever they are, it'll find them. And then it'll move. My strip probably needs to be a little bit more narrow, maybe an eighth of an inch. But see how that slides through there? Let's trim it. Let's just trim it and make it. Where is this trimmer? Do you think this trimmer will cut it? That way it'll slide a little bit easier. Okay, find your magnets. Now it does slide a little bit better. I don't know, it's a little tight still. All right, so you see how that's made? Easy? I think so. I mean, okay, maybe a little bit complicated, but once you do it once, it totally makes sense. All right, put adhesive there on the black part. Are you guys still with me? You're very quiet. She had a makeover, Joan. Yeah, that's what I was thinking was gonna happen. That's, yeah, okay. you were right there with me. You knew what I was saying. It's like, seemed like a strange matchup from her last appearance. All right, now, you guys, are you still there? Nobody's saying anything. Watching intently. Okay. Suddenly, I was like hearing crickets. Okay, so see how I put adhesive here and dimensionals there, and we're just going to line it up right there. Okay. Now, oh, I forgot to put this, but that's okay. We can still do it. We'll glue it behind. I was going to put this on there before I glued it down, but it'll be just fine like this too. We're going to slide that behind there, the fire, like it's driving through the fire. And like that. I love the fire. Fire makes it really fun. Okay. Now, take your little black and white checkered flags, and we're going to adhere them kind of crisscross like that. And again, a little bow. What do you guys think? Yes? No? Too much? Just right? Fun? I hope you like it. I was excited by it. I thought, this is fun. I don't have boys, but maybe someday I'll have grandsons and I can make cute little cards like this for them. Hopefully someday, not in the near future. I'm not ready for that. I do have a nephew. I have two nephews, actually, that I could give this to. All right, there you go. Racing by. I don't know why that is still sticking. Let's look at the other one. The other one did much better. See, even with that wobbly, here's my other one. I need to thicken that one up. This one is real good. That's how it should slide. I think maybe I have some adhesive on this. I think, yeah, see right there, there's some adhesive. Maybe that's what's holding us up. Little glue dot craziness. Got a little too crazy with the glue dots. Let's see if that works, if that fixes things. Still sticking. All right, well, I'm not going to sit here and try to fix it while you guys wait. Oh, that's a little bit better. There we go. All right, there we go. Card number two. A little bit of work. I know, it's a little bit of work, but I think it's fun. Okay, one more. Yes, Patricia, your grandson would love it. 4 years old. Oh, that's such a good age. I remember those days. When they were cute and sweet and funny, and they didn't like get mad at everything you said. They didn't argue. I have one that just, if I say, it's a beautiful day outside, the sun is shining, it's 80 degrees, no humidity, she'll say, it's a terrible day outside. Just because she has to disagree. She didn't do well on an exam. She was upset, and I was trying to tell her the reasons that she shouldn't be upset, and she just was arguing with everything, and I was like, okay, I don't have it in me to continue this argument. I mean, man, teenagers. I know. Some of you are right there with me. Some of you have been there. Whew. I love them to death, but man, 69 and rainy. Becky, I kind of do like that weather because we never have it here. 69 and rainy. Sounds like a good nap day. Okay, remember last week I said, you guys, I need some ideas for Nancy. You have a husband who does that. That's funny. I need ideas. I couldn't come up with a treat idea for this, right? You guys gave me two great ideas. The fruit snacks, and then the fast break. So I went to Walmart. I was looking for both. I couldn't find the fruit snacks. I went to find the fast break. And when I was there at the register, at the counter, I found these Reese's medals, chocolate medals. I guess they're for the Olympics. And this, I was like, okay, wait, that's perfect because we have a trophy and we have a ribbon and it's a race and they can win a medal, a chocolate medal. So cute, so cute. I've never seen these. I guess they're just special because of the Olympics. So Walmart checkout aisle. I also linked them on Amazon for you. Oh, by the way, those magnets too. You always ask me, they're linked today in today's post too. Okay, Stacy, have the gray hair to prove it. My gray hair is, yes, making itself known. Thank you, daughter number three. Daughter number three. they all have a part in it, don't they? She can't take all the blame. She can't. Okay, let's make the box first. It is a slider box. You know, Kimberly, I thought I wasn't going to find a good treat for this. I thought the fast break, I did really like that idea. I was really trying to think of something different, and that one was different. So I was like, yes, that's totally good. I do love those Nutrageous ones, those fast break ones. Okay, first thing you're going to need for the little tray that pulls out, you're going to need a piece of pumpkin pie that is 8 1/4 by 6. And we're going to score it at 1 and 2, 1 and 2, all the way around. Okay, 1, 2, 1, and 2. And then you're going to need another piece of pumpkin pie that is 7 3/8 by 4 3/8. We're going to score the long side at 1 1/8, 3 1/8, 4 1/4, and 6 1/4. That's the little tunnel that it's going to slide in and out of. All right, let's do this part first. This is a double-walled box for two reasons. Reason number one is it's going to strengthen the sides of the box. When you're pulling a box in and out of something, I feel like you need to kind of reinforce the sides so that it's thicker and stronger. And then reason number two is that it gives a nice round edge to our tray. So burnish these lines, and then what you're going to do is cut out the three outside, like the L, the little Tetris piece, okay, the L. And let me get my bigger scissors. Where are they? When you do this, I'll do that part first. We'll cut out the L. I'm saying it's an L because when these three pieces are connected, they make an L. All right, see that? But you're also going to cut in here and just cut off those corners, all right? Now, you can kind of do that all at once by cutting all the way in and cutting all the way in, but you have to really think about what you're doing because you will cut off that flap. Ask me how I know. If I'm not concentrating, I always end up cutting off this little flap right here, and you've got to have that little flap. So I'm coming in from the short side, and I'm cutting all the way down to that second score line, and then cutting that off, and that one, and then a little snip, and a little snip. Okay, again, one more time. Have you guys, my daughter, same daughter, is, you know how at the end of school year they're bored and they're not doing anything in class? Well, she has become obsessively playing Monopoly Go. And she, I don't like to play games on my phone, but she made me download it. And now I'm playing it. And I'm like, why am I doing this? I can't stop playing it. Are any of you playing Monopoly Go? It's the most dumb game. You need no skill. You just push a button. If you're looking for a new game, download it. Unless you are like, nope, I'm not going to waste my time. I'm going to read a book. That's what I'm always thinking. I should be reading a book. I'm cutting off the corners. She even texts me from school and will say, hey, can you send me this sticker that I need for Monopoly Go? Or can you accept my request for blah, blah, blah? I'm like, child, I am trying to work, not play Monopoly Go. Oh, May. May is a fun one in the schools. They've had tests. They'll have a test, and then they'll have these long periods of nothing where they're doing nothing in any of their classes. Okay, I digress. This is what your piece looks like. All right. I kind of trimmed off the corners of all the outside tabs as well. I'm going to take, you know what, Nancy, you're right. Games give your brain a chance to turn off for a while. Maybe that's why I like it. You're right. Because sometimes our brain just really does need a little break. You're right. You know what? I like that, Nancy. All right. Fold this in like this. Okay. And these little tabs that we just put adhesive on are going to fold up into that side like that. And then fold up like that. I am reading the very last book in the almost a Game of Thrones, but that's not it. Glass Throne series by Sarah J. Maas. I think that's her name. Have you guys read this? I have spent the last 5 months reading every single one of her books, and I'm on the very last one, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I loved all of her books. They're like sci-fi fantasy, which I don't normally read. I go through periods of it, but if you like that, some of them are spicy, I will say that. Some of them are not spicy. Again, depends on, wait, let's hold on. Depends on what you're looking for. Fold these in. This is going to give you that double-walled box, but very good. You know, when you find an author that you like and then you read every single one of their books and then you're like, oh, now what? Now what am I going to do? Now what? All right. We've made our little tray. It's ready. We're going to let it dry. The little tunnel, you just are going to fold it in into itself. I'm just going to use my stamp and seal, and we're going to line these up like this and make a tunnel for our box. Okay? Okay. Next, again, I was really struggling with what paper to use. I know, Kimberly, they can't write fast enough. And then I worry about some of the ones like Outlander has been going on for so long. Like, what if she doesn't finish? You know, like, what if something happens to her and she doesn't get to finish it? I know. All right. We're going to use sketched plaid. I was calling it stylish sketch. That's not it. Sketched plaid background stamp. Basic gray cardstock, basic gray ink. Lay that down. Now, this is a much bigger piece than I need. You're going to cut this down, which I've already done, 2, 4, 1/8 by 1 7/8. Okay? That's going to go on the top of our box. Let's stamp our little car. This time, we are gonna use the little outline. You know what, I think I'm gonna use basic gray since it's open. And we're gonna use blueberry bushel. You know, I've noticed lately, I've been really using blueberry bushel a lot. I really like blueberry bushel. It's a really good blue. All right, get this one, the little car with the star. And I can't decide if it's easier to stamp the outline first and then stamp the inside, or stamp the inside first and then stamp the outline. What do you guys think? This one, I can't even see it, it's so dirty. Let's clean it. I think it's the other way. I think the outline first and then the inside. But mess around with yours, see which way you like it, which way is better for you. That one is better. I think for me, it's better to do the outline first. Okay, then we've got to do our little ribbon and our little trophy. So cute. Don't forget your tires. Decide, I like this tire better than the other one. It's more exciting than just the plain old tire. Now, coloring. We don't have a gold marker. Susan, you love blueberry bushel? Yes. Bye, Laura, you're gonna, okay, you're leaving, bye. We don't have a gold marker, but what we do have is wild wheat. And check it out. Doesn't it look gold? Wild wheat. Thank you to my downline, Deanna, who pointed that out to me last year when wild wheat was new and I was being very judgy and I was saying, I don't like wild wheat. And then she said, Erica, it looks like gold. You need to reevaluate. And she was absolutely right. So I am gonna use wild wheat here and it's gonna look like a gold trophy. Now take your dark and just go like along the left side like this, just to give it a little bit of a shadow like that. Then take your Wink of Stella and add some shimmer to it, and then it really looks like gold. All right, and then the ribbon. Oh, I brought my glasses for this because I absolutely cannot see this. We're gonna color every other one. Okay, every other one like that. What's for dinner tonight, you guys? What's for dinner? Friday night, I never know what to get for dinner. It's our takeout night, and we can never decide what we want. It's the night I don't cook. All right, get your paper snips, my friends, and cut them out. Don't say pizza. Although I do like pizza, I don't need to be eating pizza. Tacos, Michelle. Tacos are a good choice. We haven't had tacos in a long time. My daughter, we could eat pizza a lot. And it's just, you know, so good. You know, Pizza Hut doesn't deliver to my house. I'm not that far from my old house, but they don't deliver out here. Like, what the heck? It's very strange. We like Pizza Hut, but now we can't get it out here. Okay. Two different pieces of Designer Series paper. This is the Nature's Sweetness paper that was in the spring catalog that carried over, actually. It's still available. I think it's maybe an online exclusive. All right, now I've got two strips. That one is probably an inch, and this one is probably 3/4 of an inch. And we're just cutting a V in each end. Like that. And now we're gonna layer it all up. Let's start with, Roxanne, I'll be over tonight. That sounds delicious. Lasagna and rhubarb pie. Your son had his wisdom teeth out, mashed potatoes for summer. That's funny. My daughter needs to get her wisdom teeth out. And I have been putting it off and putting it off. My first daughter, when she had her wisdom teeth out, we had all kinds of problems. So I'm kind of like, ugh. All right, dimensionals. I had problems when I got my wisdom teeth out too. So now, you know, we don't have a good track record. Yeah, lasagna sounds amazing. I've been on a soup kick lately. I just want soup all the time. I love soup. Even when it's hot, I still like soup. Okay, so look how cute that is. Way to go. And then you put it with your little metal chocolate. How cute. Teacher appreciation. This would be great for teacher appreciation. Or, like my kids, taking lots of tests. My daughter got her SAT scores yesterday. She got a 1250, which she was very excited about. We were all like, wow, because none of us got 1250s. She is number like 19 in her class out of like 750. She's real smart. She is really hoping for some merit scholarships. So she's been working really, really hard. Really hard. You know, when you're the middle child of three sisters and your dad has to pay for three colleges, you really try to get as much merit as you can so you can go to the school you want to go to. All right, layered it all up with dimensionals, okay? She is our smarty pants for sure. She's going to be an astrophysicist, not an astrologist. We tease her. Astrology? She's not astrology. Astrophysicist. I don't know what it is. It's something way above my brain capacity. She's very smart. She's our science girl. The 1250, I was pretty impressed. She said the SAT this year was very, very hard. Okay, tie your ribbon around the box like that. And then you're going to slide it in. Yes, Jana, I think that is what Sheldon Cooper is, right? I think so. Yeah. Ooh, taco soup, Lisa. Yes, that sounds delicious. I think you're exactly right. That's what Sheldon Cooper is. Now, I watched Big Bang Theory on and off, but now I feel like I need to watch Big Bang Theory so I can understand all the references to his family that are in young Sheldon. But that's a big commitment. I mean, how many episodes are there of the Big Bang Theory? There are a lot. Maybe that's just what I'm going to do this summer. Sheldon Cooper and I, all summer. All right, boom, we're done. Look at that. How cute and how fun. Walmart, also Amazon. And you know how Reese's makes like the chocolate Christmas trees and the chocolate pumpkins? They always taste better to me than the actual Reese's peanut butter cup. That's what these are like too. Okay, you guys, what do you think? I think that'd make a great teacher appreciation gift. And if you have a male teacher, a man, sometimes we don't know what to give our male teachers. This would be great. The stamp set would be great. Okay, we are done. I want to show you a couple of other things. Yeah, Michelle, my daughter was watching Grey's Anatomy also. 19 seasons. I don't think I could stick with it for that long. That's a very long time. Played Aunt Jackie on Roseanne is the actual mom to be. Okay, wait a minute. The lady that plays his mom in Big Bang Theory played Aunt Jackie on Roseanne and is the actual mom to the actress who plays young Sheldon's mom. Okay, Janet just blew my mind. That is crazy. I remember. I know who she is. I know exactly who that is. Okay. This week, if you would like these three projects for free as a make and take kit that I mail to you, make sure that your order is in by Monday at midnight using this host code. Minimum order, $35. Okay. Now I have two bonus cards. Did you guys see this one I posted yesterday? This is that paper. And now I'm not going to remember the name of it. I'll have to look back on my blog post. It's all watercolor and it's kind of busy. And you're kind of like, I don't know what to do with it. Well, using it like that, where you put a center or focal point in the middle. And then everything else, this and this and the balloons, are all from our ephemera packs. Have you looked at those? We have four different, I hope I'm saying it right, ephemera packs. They're all little like die cuts that you punch out that you can just throw onto your card. It makes for a really quick and easy card. So this card is definitely going to be fast and easy compared to this card. All right, so take your pick, whichever one you want to do. So that was yesterday. And then on Monday, I've got this one. I made these tires to go in the back, but they look like records. Don't they? They don't look like tires. Oh, well, whatever. I knew what I meant. They look like, there should be tires. But here's that little card, just like we did on the box as well. So that'll be on Monday. All right, you guys, that is it. Let me know if you have questions. Thanks for joining me today. It was fun. I hope you guys enjoyed these projects. And I will see you next week. Next week, I believe we're going to do Friendly Fens. The little sharks, little shark, the stingray. I'm having trouble with a treat for that one as well. So if you have any ideas for that, please message me. Something I can get easy, like at Walmart, Target, you know, something easy. All right, you guys, have a wonderful weekend. I'll see you next week. Thanks. Bye.